Welcome to our newest episode of the eAcademy, in which we continue to talk about the PERFECTA control panels. We will show you how to set up a simple cable system based on the PERFECTA panel using PERFECTA Soft software. Today we will use a PC with Windows operating system, a USB RS converter to connect the computer to the panel, a complete set of PERFECTA 16 panel in casing, a keypad PRF LCD, a curtain detector, agate, an internal optical and acoustic siren, SPW220R, as well as the PERFECTA Soft software, which is available for download on our website. The panel which we are going to set up has been turned on for the first time. We start by connecting it to the computer using the USB RS converter. We will show you how easy it is to use PERFECTA Soft software. We will go step by step through the subsequent stages of creating a simple alarm system. We will also show you how the software indicates which devices have already been connected to the panel and which can still be connected. The intuitive interface makes the installer's work much easier. It will also be interesting to those who, until now, have preferred to manage and set up the system solely via the keypad. Now we will launch the PERFECTA Soft software. In the left menu, we choose the button New. A list of four PERFECTA control panel models will appear. Here you need to choose the relevant one. In our case, it's PERFECTA 16. Now we can see a window on the screen where we enter the basic information about the created system. We will call ours eAcademy 37. It's important to give each system a separate name. This will help us later to differentiate among the saved setting files. Next, in the top right corner of the screen, we find the additional menu icon. We choose Connection. In the field Port RS232, we choose the COM port number as assigned to the connected converter. We click OK. To establish connection with the control panel, click the Connect button next to the COM port number as chosen earlier. A notice on connecting with a new panel and a question for reading the data will pop up. Confirm by clicking Yes. Correct connection will be confirmed with an indicator blinking on the top bar together with the model and firmware version of the panel. We can also see the indication of time as set in the panel. Now we will show you how you can send system time and date from the computer to the panel. Click on the clock icon. We confirm by clicking Send. As you can see, the time displayed has been changed. Another indicator visible on the menu bar is the trouble icon. Let's check what kind of troubles are signaled by the system and whether they could be deleted. After choosing the trouble icon, a list appears. You can see the clock trouble memory, which occurred after the panel had been launched. Let's delete this information. Now let's move on to the hardware tab. A list of devices will appear. Those which have already been identified in our system are marked in green. Icons of other devices which can be added to the system are marked in grey. At the moment, there are only two defined elements, the main board of the panel and a GSM panel. Now Match A will perform identification of devices connected to the panel board. We showed you how to do it quickly using service functions in our previous episode. To check whether the keypad connected to the panel has been identified correctly, we have to read the data. So we click the down arrow button on the menu bar. We can see that a keypad with the address 0 has appeared on our device list. When we select it, a list of options available for this device will appear. Here we can configure, for example, the volume of the sounds played for different events. As you can see, the changed parameters are marked in red. This is how PERFECTA Soft software marks the differences between the setup visible on the computer screen and the current settings of our alarm system. The above-mentioned red markings of parameters is not only valid for numeral data, but also for any settings that have been changed. Let's move on to the main board and check Do Not Arm if Tampered. As you can see, the software also marked this changed option in red. Now we will send the data to the control panel. To do this, we click the up arrow button on the menu bar. During our first attempt to send data, the software will ask us to enter the panel key. The key is the identification number of our alarm control panel, which consists of up to 16 signs, alphanumeric characters. You can set it yourself or use the line of characters as generated by the PERFECTA Soft software. We click OK. The data has been sent. Two important comments. Firstly, we do not recommend that you use the same key for different alarm control panels. In the case of managing more than one PERFECTA panel, it may cause problems with identification. Secondly, the communication between PERFECTA Soft software and the alarm control panel is possible when the keys are identical both in the software and in the panel. Now we will move on to set zones. Our panel can manage up to 16 zones, of which 8 are physically available on the mainboard. To increase their number to the maximum, connect the INTE zones expander to the panel. We choose the zone tab. A list of all zones and their parameters will appear. Some of the options depend on the chosen type of circuit or reaction. We have connected a gate curtain detector to zone number 1 of our panel. So we also change the name of the zone in the software. We choose the circuit type as 2EOL/NC and set the reaction type as entry exit. In this case, we can set the entry delay. By default, it is 30 seconds. We change this value to 10 seconds. Every detector in the system can be configured in a similar manner. Important note. In PERFECTA panels, any zone may be assigned to one or both partitions at the same time. It is possible to set the system so that the particular zone is armed while any of the partitions are armed. Another option is for the integrated zone to be armed only when both partitions are armed at the same time. Moreover, we can define whether a particular zone will be active with day or night guard mode on. You can also find information about the zones in the Partitions tab. You will also find there a chart with information on which zones are assigned to which partitions and their activity in different arming modes. Below you will find Time Parameters Configuration field. We will make a few changes. Now, we will add an internal optical and acoustic siren, SPW220R, to our system. We open the tab Outputs. We connect an optical signaling to output number 1, an acoustic signaling to output number 2. We change the names and leave the assignment of the outputs to both partitions. We also choose the type of output, internal siren. We can also define the cutoff time, which you should bear in mind, especially when setting the acoustic signaling. An empty field means that the siren will be active until the alarm is deleted. After all the changes have been made, we send the data to the panel. The remaining outputs may be used, for example, to control the electrical devices connected to the system, including lighting. Now it's worth verifying if the state of zones and outputs are consistent with our assumptions. To do this, we open the list with the status of partitions outputs and zones. Now, we will arm both partitions and set off the alarm to show you how the status is indicated. Next to partitions, zones and outputs, you can see different symbols. After moving the mouse over a particular symbol, a window appears in its description. For example, a green key means arm and red bell an alarm. It is worth knowing that we can verify the correctness of outputs by launching a simulation of their status via the keypad. To do this, we enter the service password and confirm it with an asterisk. Choose 92. We choose outputs with arrows one by one. We change their status with the hash and numerical keys. Now we can see our siren is working. Another important step in creating a system is adding its users. So let's move on to the Users tab. You can see a list of 15 users. Each of them can be assigned a name and a password, and we can indicate which partitions the given person may manage. We also choose the authorization scheme. Now we will check what authority level we can assign to different users. There are 5 predefined schemes. We can see that the authorization schemes enable flexible adjustment and division of users in accordance with expectations. Finally, we send the data to the panel again. and that's how we prepare the initial setup of a very simple cable system. Based on these presented examples, we can keep developing and adjusting it to the user's needs. In the following episode, we will show you how to prepare a configuration of a simple wireless system via PERFECTA Soft. That's all for today. Thank you, and hope you will join us for the next episode of the eAcademy. See you!